a long time since I've been asking for. What did you say?
On the plains of Kansas. A humble farmhouse stands alone in the cornfields. Uncle Henry and Aunt Em are resting after a hard day's work. Nearby, in her own room, their niece Dorothy lies dreaming of the many wonderful adventures she's had in the magical land of Oz, far, far away. She and her little dog Toto both miss their friends there, and by now, even Aunt Em and Uncle Henry are beginning to believe in Oz. What they don't know is that tonight there's magic in the air. A spell sent from a distant land is drawing ever nearer. Softly calling, beckoning, pleading. Governed by some invisible distant power, the spell gains strength, reaches out, takes hold. The magic shoes that once carried Dorothy home from Oz begin to glow. A mysterious tick, tick disturbs her rest. The spell has Dorothy in its power. Vanished without so much as rattling a dish in the little farmhouse. Without her magic shoes, Dorothy is stranded in Oz once again. But where in Oz?
Roll, roll, roll your wheel, roll it all about. Merrily, scarily, whirly, harily, keep all stranger down.
We are nasty.
We are mean.
We scare folks we never see!
Toto's in the henhouse. Huh? Where am I? What's going on?
Get up, stranger! Yeah, get out!
You're trespassing.
Hey, what are you waiting for?
Who are you, anyway? You don't live around these parts.
My name is Dorothy, and I'm from Kansas. Now, whoever you are, mind your manners. If you're trying to scare me, it won't work.
Huh? Hmm. Of course it will. We scare everybody.
Well, you don't scare me.
We do so.
That's what you think.
Yeah, never ran into this before.
Look, we're wheelers, and we're mean.
Well, maybe I am, too, so don't try anything.
How did you get here without wheel?
Let me see. I was asleep in bed and suddenly I was flying. flying through the air.
Huh? You're flying or asleep?
I could have imagined it. I don't know myself. There was a ticking sound. Someone called my name and I took off.
Then what happened?
I flew a long way, and when I woke up, I was lying over there.
Huh? That's the tallest tale I've ever heard. Either you're lying or you're some kind of witch.
No!
Yeah, either you're lying or you're some kind of witch and use magic to get here.
We hate witches.
But I'm not a witch, really, I'm not. I have no idea how I got here.
Hey, hold it, boys. What if she's working with that metal man who keeps trying to rob us?
Oh, metal man? Do you mean my friend Tim Ann is here? But he never tried to rob you.
Hear that? She even knows his name, boys. And he did try to rob us, and I bet you're here to help him. And I still say you're a witch, and we don't want you around here, so there.
Yes, there.
Would you please stop yelling? Nothing makes me angrier than being yelled at.
Hey, wait. If anyone's going to get angry around here, it's us. Get angry, boys.
Brought you here.
Your signal? I don't know what you mean, TikTok.
Well, I sent my emergency talk tickety distress signal to get you.
Huh? Your distress signal brought me all the way from Kansas?
That's right. You're famous for saving people, so my maker made sure when my key is unwound, you'd come save me. By the way, you haven't seen those nasty wheelers, have you? They're the ones who unwound me. Not that I was doing anything wrong, really. You see, I'm here on a mission.
What kind of mission?
A top secret mission, Dorothy. I can't tell you a word about it, but don't worry, it's all above board.
Oh, I see. A secret mission that's all above board. Sounds pretty peculiar to me. Especially since the Wheelers said you tried to rob them.
The Wheelers said what? Oh, no, Dorothy, you've got it all wrong. Well, almost all wrong, but you'll see. For now, trust me, Princess Lulu would never ask you to do anything wrong.
Well, at Please tell me who Princess Lulu is.
Huh? Oh, I can't. She'd take away my key if she found out I'd even mentioned her name. She's a good princess, but... Oh, no. I almost told you what she was like anyway, and that could have been trouble. She's very touchy, you know. Changes her moods like some people change hats. There I go again. Why can't I learn to keep my mechanical mouth shut? Now I've told you about her hats, too. Oh, this is awful. Please, don't ask me if Princess Lulu sent me to get a Wheeler's hat. I might let it slip out. No!
Listen, Tick-Tock, even though I'd like to ask lots of questions about Princess Lulu, I don't want you to get into trouble. So why don't we think about something else for a while? Like what we're going to do next?
Good question, Dorothy. Let me think. Let's see now.
Tick-Tock, what's wrong? Oh, you need to be wound up again, is that it? Goodness, you do seem to wind down rather quickly. Is that better?
Hey! Thank you, Dorothy. I'm right back to full strength. One, two. By the way, do we know what we're doing next yet?
No, but I think up is the answer. We have to keep going up the mountain to get away from the Wheelers.
Oh, I see. They can't use their wheels to climb up the mountain, so they wouldn't be able to follow us, would they?
No, but the trouble is, once we get to the top, where do we go from there?
Oh, dear, I see what you mean. Hold on. Let me check something. According to my inner ticker... We're in practically no danger at all. In fact, we don't have to go up. It's safe enough to go down.
You mean the Wheelers won't get us?
Oh, I doubt it. My inner ticker's only at 1 o'clock, and that's the lowest danger level there is, Dorothy. Oh, dear.
What is it?
Last-minute warning.
Oh?
Wheelers in the area. Boy, my ticker doesn't miss a trick, does it?
Oh, no. I could have told it that. Come on, Tick-Tock. Let's just get going. Shh, here's the road.
Any sign of them?
No.
I'll peek around that bend.
Right.
Let me see. Come on, Dorothy. Not a Wheeler in sight. Let's get going while the going's good.
They must have given up and gone home. With any luck, we've seen the last of them.
Uh-huh. Well, for now, we'll still have to see them sometime if we're going to perform our secret mission. Not that I'm looking forward to seeing them again.
What? You mean we have to go looking for the week?
Look around. See anything?
No.
That's odd. My inner ticker said 6 o'clock all of a sudden. I wonder why.
Maybe it knows how fed up I am with this secret mission business.
We can play it safe and go back up if you like.
No, I've come this far. I'll see it through.
You mean you'll help even though I can't tell you what it is?
No, I mean I can't leave you to take the Wheelers on alone.
Thanks, Dorothy. I really appreciate... They're coming!
They're
killing fire!
I told you they were working together. Run them down! Forget, but first we're gonna flatten them!
All right, if that's how you want it, I'm a witch. Remember, one move and I'll turn you into stone.
What? Take it easy. Yeah, we were probably just kidding. We were only going to scare him a bit.
Phew. Well, now that's settled, here's what I'll do. I'll go and see Princess Lulu myself and tell her not to send TikTok back here again.
How do we know she's going to do what you say?
Easy. She won't want to be turned to stone any more than you do.
Well, that should get her attention, all right. But I'm warning you, we catch you round our hats again, we'll threaten to flatten him and scare the daylights out of him from dawn to dusk and throw away his key. Come on, boys, we call them witches.
Yeah, one little crack.
Oh, thank you, Dorothy. You sure saved me that time.
You're welcome.
But was I surprised? I never knew you were a witch.
Of course I'm not a witch. I had to tell them something, or who knows what they would have done. Anyway, let's go see this princess.
Huh? Oh, no, Dorothy, don't go near Lulu. She's so strange. She's dangerous.
Look, I told the Wheelers I'd go, and I intend to keep my word. So lead on. Which way do we go?
Oh, well, let's see. The castle's over that way.
Tell me about her on the way, TikTok, and about this country. I've never been here before.
This is the land of Ev.
The land of Ev? I've never heard of it. Is Princess Lulu its ruler? And is it anywhere near Oz?
I've never heard of Oz, but one thing I can tell you, Lulu is the ruler of Ev, and a more peculiar ruler you've never seen anywhere.
She collects hats, hmm?
Oh, yes, anything she can wear on her head.
Oh, but collecting hats isn't all that peculiar. People collect all kinds of things. Where I come from, a lot of people collect stamps.
Oh, but the princess is no ordinary collector. You see, when she puts on one of her hats, her whole personality changes to match whatever hat she's wearing. It's really something to see, and sometimes it's scary.
But what do you mean her personality changes to match the hat she's wearing, TikTok?
Just what I said. You'll see when we get to the castle. If she's wearing a soldier's hat, she'll feel like fighting. If she's wearing a bathing cap, she'll feel like going for a swim. Knock. But remember, her personality will match whatever hat she's wearing.
Well, here goes. Anybody home? Hello? Princess Lulu?
Who's this, TikTok? And where is the hat the princess ordered? Didn't you get it?
Sorry.
Your secret mission failed?
This is quite disappointing. The princess will be furious when she is informed of this disgraceful lapse on your part. You know how much she wanted a Wheeler hat.
That's why I'm here, miss. May I see the princess?
Who is this strange girl, TikTok?
I'm sorry, I should have introduced myself, miss. My name's Dorothy, and I'm from Kansas.
She won't like it.
She must have hundreds of hats. Why try and steal more of them?
One moment.
That's not a servant, Dorothy. That's the princess.
Oh!
She's probably gone to put on her princess hat right now.
Oh, are you ready to see them, Your Highness?
Oh, I suppose so. Oh, it's all such a bore.
Dorothy of Kansas, Your Highness. Dorothy from the Kingdom of Kansas? Never heard of it. And I've heard of all the kingdoms worth being heard of around here.
I'm here to ask why you steal hats.
A princess does it. It's royal tribute, not theft. Everything really belongs to me. I merely take whatever I want, whenever I want it. It's my right. So there!
Your Highness, princess or not, taking what's not yours is called stealing where I come from.
Come up here and say that, my dear.
Huh?
Go on.
Well, hurry up, hurry up. I haven't got all day. I don't like dawdlers, Dorothy! What is it that I find so irritating about you? Let me see. Imagine being hatless. But you're not even wearing a ribbon or a hatpin. Shameful. Well, I could make a hat from your hair.
No! You can't have my hair. I don't care if you're a princess or not. You're very, very rude, Lulu. Your manners are atrocious, and real royalty doesn't go around stealing hats from poor people.
you two later on. But right now, I have guests arriving, and I must go select what hat I shall wear.
Oh, we haven't done anything wrong. Why do you have to lock us up?
You hurt me. You made me cry.
Goodness, her moods do change fast, don't they, TikTok?
It's that hat. She always acts like that when she's wearing it. You ought to see her with her crash helmet on.
No, makes me feel blue. I've got to find a hat that'll give me lots of charm. I have to be at my best for this conference with Ozma. I need her help, so my mood must be enchanting. No, too bossy. Ah! Too childish. Oh, what to wear? Oh, I need a hat that'll make me gentle and sweet. Something lovey-dovey.
Dorothy, my ticker senses something. Something very close by.
Oh.
Oh, it's detecting a scratching noise. Now it senses a long tail and very sharp teeth.
Oh, look, over there.
Oh, my. Oh. Oh, I hope it's not a monster.
A mouse. Oh, boy, what a relief, TikTok.
Yes.
How you doing? I'm just looking for scraps. I don't see a crumb. Most prisoners leave something for me.
I'm made of metal, Mr. Mouse, so I don't eat. And Lulu hasn't said anything for Dorothy.
Dorothy? The Dorothy who's so famous in Oz? Wow! This is a real thrill, Dorothy. I've heard about you from my cousins in Oz.
I may know some of your cousins. The Mouse Queen has helped me many times. Say, you must know where Oz is.
Well, sure I do. Yes, sirree.
Oh, that's good news. TikTok's never heard of it. Is Oz very far from here?
Well, it's not right in our backyard, and you have to cross a desert to get to it, but it's not all that far, nope.
Dorothy, may I ask a question?
Of course.
Maybe if Mr. Mouse didn't mind you being a friend of the Mouse Queens and all, he could help us get out of this place. We could be stuck here forever knowing Lulu.
Of course.
I know it's a lot to ask.
An awful lot, but if he would...
I'd be honored to help in any way I can.
Oh, thank you.
Here come Princess Lulu's guests, and they're none other than Ozma, Scarecrow, the Tin Woodman, and Jack Pumpkinhead. Their friend the Mouse scampers off unnoticed in the excitement of their arrival. Princess Lulu greets her distinguished visitors.
Welcome!
Not very long after, in one of the great forests of Oz...
Your Majesty! Your Majesty! Hey, wake up, Your Majesty! Come on!
Mr. Mouse, I hope you've got a good reason for waking me.
Oh, I do. Friends of yours are in big trouble.
Oh, well, that's different. I'll come right along as soon as I finish. Oh, my dream. Be with you in a flash, Mr. Mouse.
No, wait. You can't sleep now. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up.
Stop doing that. Look, will you leave me alone?
No. No, this is an emergency. You're the only one who can help.
I can't help if I'm exhausted. I need my sleep, you know. Can't be brave and daring if you're too pooped to stand up.
No.
Besides, I was dreaming of when Dorothy was here.
But Dorothy is here. She's the one who's in trouble. Lulu's put her in the dungeon in the land of Ev. And we all know what Lulu's like. Who knows what she might do?
Dorothy's here? Oh, this is wonderful news. Of course, it's awful that Lulu's got her, though.
You're not kidding? Why do you think I wouldn't let you sleep, Your Majesty? We've got to get her out, and soon.
Take me to her, Mr. Mouse. I'll get her out no matter what hat Lulu's wearing.
Now you're talking, Your Majesty.
Lion and the Mouse hurry back to the land of Ev, where Lulu is in conference with her guests.
About this help you desperately need, Princess Lulu. If you
like my hat, doesn't make me look like a bird brain, does it?
Oh, no. It's, well, it's unique. That's what it is.
Oh, I knew you'd like it. I mean, you have to admit you can't get much more lovey-dovey than this. But now my problem is that my sweet little brother, the Prince of Ev, was captured by the Gnome King and is being held prisoner in Gnomeland, his underground kingdom.
I see. So you want us to go and rescue the prince, is that it?
You'll do it! I know I can count on you! Oh, I'm so happy. I could just cry. My brother's going to be rescued at last. Oh, I've been so miserable without him. I love him as much as my hats. Oh, my hats. They've been so lonely without me. I'm down to a dozen a day.
And I'm getting sick of wearing that silly old crown. Nothing's quite so dull as royal headgear.
So you see, you must rescue the prince. For my sake, you wouldn't want poor me to rule the land of Ev forever, would you?
Oh, no!
It is a rather chilling thought, Lulu.
Oh, we wouldn't want that. No, we'll do it.
Oh, goody. Can I go too, Ozma? I'd be good honest.
Sorry, Jack, but we won't be going. I have a country of my own to rule. Lulu, I can't desert Oz for as long as it would take to rescue him. I'm sorry.
But, Ozma, if we don't go, that leaves only Tin Man and Scarecrow, and they can't do it all alone.
Jack's right. The odds against us will be far too great. I'm afraid we won't be able to help after all.
Oh, how will I ever get my poor prince back?
Sorry, Princess Lulu. We could have done it in the good old days, if only Lion and Dorothy were here.
What I'd give to hear lions roar. All right, Lulu, where is she?
Lion, are you feeling all right?
Scarecrow, hey, are you in on this?
In on what?
Tin Man, what? You didn't help Lulu put Dorothy in the dungeon, did you?
Of course not. Are you saying Dorothy's in Lulu's dungeon, Lion? Our Dorothy?
According to Mr. Mouse.
Oh, I can't believe I'd put your Dorothy in the dungeon, whoever she is.
Oh, yeah? Well, I can, Lulu. I intend to go down and have a look around for myself. Nobody locks up Dorothy, understand?
The truth, Lulu. Is she down there or not?
Ouch! This cat has a temper.
It's a man!
I'm out!
Lulu, couldn't you try to act normal for a change?
I'm as normal as the rest of you, maybe even more normal.
Her moods change too fast for me.
Maybe we should just find Dorothy and go. I just wish we'd been able to help your brother, Princess Lulu.
Hey, everybody, I just thought of something. Once we free Dorothy, then the four of us will be back together again. We can all go and rescue the Prince of Ev.
Tin Man, how clever! Now I can return to Oz knowing that you four are certain to succeed.
Wait, why don't I send TikTok along as my contribution?
TikTok? Who's he?
You'll love him. He's mechanical. He can do all sorts of things.
He sounds good to me. We'll take any help we can get. We're off on an adventure.
Hey!
Friends are off to Gnomeland to rescue the Prince of Ev, with TikTok as their guide.
I'm glad to get away from Lulu. I'm afraid she makes a terrible ruler. Anyone whose mood changes to match her hat is hardly likely to go far, but I've had to serve her ever since the prince was captured. He's my true master, you know, and a very good ruler indeed. Oh, I'm so glad Princess Lulu sent me along to be your guide. I'm TikTok old Pink.
Just how much further is it?
Oh, just a few days, if we make it through the dangerous desert.
Huh? Dangerous desert?
That's what it's called, but I don't know why. I don't know anyone who's crossed it.
Oh, great.
Oh, what are those over there? Maybe we should go over and take a look. Oh, amazing.
Are these what I think they are?
If it's bones you're thinking of, Dorothy, that's what they look like to me.
What could have been so big?
I can only think of a whale.
Maybe you're right. Look at these seashells. What would they be doing in the middle of a desert?
Phew, what a ticker twister.
I've had enough excitement for one day. Let's try and find shelter. It's getting late.
Good idea, Lion. Maybe we could sleep inside one of these big fish bones.
No, thank you. I'm not that tired.
Just over the next sand dune, another surprise awaits them.
A ship?
In the middle of the desert.
It just doesn't make sense. How did it get here?
Who knows, Tin Man? It's in pretty rough shape, though.
All very intriguing. Seashells, fish bones, and the wreck of an old sailing ship. I must process this information for an explanation.
You know, it's possible that this desert was an ocean once. It's the only way the bones in the ship could get here.
I have just been given the same information.
There's the real proof that there was water here. Look at the hull of the ship.
Those are barnacles.
Right. The ship had to have been in the water to get those.
You're right.
And it can't have been here all that long either, or the wind would have buried it in the sand.
That's right.
Oh, but if this was an ocean, where did the water go?
There's another test we could do that just might help. If this used to be an ocean, then the sand should be salty.
Oh, of course. It sure smells salty.
Mm. Oh, it tastes salty too. You were right, TikTok.
I'll just make sure. Well, I can't taste anything.
Do you have a sensor for tasting things, TikTok?
I know, I forgot. My makers didn't feel it was necessary for my survival.
Well, then I say this place used to be an ocean.
I wish my ticker would talk to me. I keep asking it where the water went, but it chooses not to give me the information.
Maybe it doesn't know either.
Let's take a look around inside the ship. Maybe we could find out more.
Maybe we should split up and do a room at a time.
Good idea.
Be careful.
Ooh, this must have been the captain's quarters.
Find anything in there, Dorothy?
Nothing yet.
Nothing to report so far.
Same here.
Well, it'll make a good place to sleep.
Huh? Oh, my.
Next morning, after a good rest, they're awakened by a rooster?
It's not a rooster, it's a chicken!
Chicken?
Sounds like a rooster,
but it's a chicken, all right.
Yep, no doubt about it. No comb, no colored feathers. That's a chicken.
Maybe the desert sun has mixed her up and she thinks she's a rooster.
I've never been so insulted in all my life! How dare you! I'm a virtually normal hen, all right? If I want to grow like a rooster, that's my business. Who are you, anyway? But what are you doing aboard my ship? I didn't invite you to join me. I want some explanations, and I want them fast. Well, speak up. I'm waiting.
We're very sorry if we insulted you, but we've never seen a hen that could crow before.
I see. Well, now you have, so run along. You don't fool me. I know the Gnome King sent you to steal me.
But we weren't sneaking up on you, really. And we weren't sent to steal you by the Gnome King, either.
No? Why are you here?
We stopped here to rest. We're trying to find Gnome Land. We have to see the Gnome King.
The Gnome King? What do you want with him?
I think we should tell her it is a secret mission.
No, we can speak freely. My ticker senses she's trustworthy, loyal, and generous.
You're not so bad yourself, Buster. You're the cutest thing I've seen in years.
She also has excellent taste.
Dorothy and her friends introduce themselves and tell their peculiar new friend, who seems quite taken with TikTok, about their mission. They're hoping she can tell them how to get to Gnome Land.
So, your name is Belina, then?
Uh-huh, Belina Clockworthy.
And you work for the Gnome King?
Yep, I was the royal alarm clock and official egg layer to the king. Well, for a day. But first morning, he didn't have a spoon to clog his hard-boiled egg with, so he couldn't.
suppose that's the reason you're living here, then.
Yes, I was banished from Gnomeland forever!
But can you tell us how to get there?
Huh? Sure I can! It's right over there! See those rocks? Gnomeland's right underneath them!
Oh.
Belina wishes them well and sends them on their way.
Slowly, so you can catch up.
Oh, I wonder what Belina wants.
Brought you something to remember me by.
It did?
One custom lead-in for my favorite clockwork man.
You're very kind, but...
A token of my esteem.
But I'm mechanized, eh? If I eat an egg, it'd gum up my works.
You eat a lady friend's token of esteem?
No, never. Don't know what I was thinking of.
Well, I know what you will be thinking of every time you look at it. Me.
Sure. What am I supposed to do with an egg? Maybe I could just bury it in the sand and hope Belina doesn't find out I left it here. Not too gallant, but...
What are you doing? You're not burying it, are you?
Oh, no, no. I just, heavens, no.
Oh, that's a relief.
I'll just plop it in here. Oh, great.
They push on to the rock formations and leave the desert far behind them. But an entrance to the underground kingdom of Gnomeland is nowhere to be seen.
You're next, Scarecrow!
It's tough going and getting tougher with every step.
Second.
Well, you hung on long enough, Lion.
Where's that wind come from, anyhow?
A vast underground cavern, according to my guess-o-meter.
Another small victory. But there are new challenges waiting for them at every turn.
Watch your step, everyone. I almost prefer the hot sands of that desert to this.
I know how you feel. These rocks are treacherous.
I only hope we're getting closer to Gnomeland.
Right, Dorothy.
We've come an awfully long way, and there's still no sign of Gnomeland.
Look! What are those things over there?
Where?
See? Those tall pillars of rock.
They look like giant gateposts.
I'm sure they're an entrance. Don't they look like that to you, Scarecrow? Maybe that's the way to Gnomeland.
If that's an entrance, it doesn't look very welcoming.
Welcoming or not, we have to go see.
Oh, I suppose you're right, Dorothy. Let's go.
is indeed the entrance to Gnomeland, and they soon find themselves at the top of a staircase leading straight down.
Whoa! Oh.
Thanks. Careful, Scarecrow.
Sure is a long way down.
Let's see how long.
That's really deep.
Oh, boy. Then we've got a long trip down.
Oh, I don't mind the trip down, but it'll take a lot of winding to get me back up.
Worrying about it isn't going to make it any easier. Let's go.
I wonder how much further we have to go. I'm getting tired.
Me too.
Estimated time of arrival, sometime between any time now and much later.
Oh, very helpful, TikTok.
Thank you.
See if I can calm him down.
Hey, look down there. If that's what Scarecrow saw, I don't blame him for running away.
A river of fire.
Correction, a river of molten rock, Dorothy. Rock that has become so hot in the depths of this volcano that it has melted down to liquid form. It's called lava, actually.
Lava, huh? Well, whatever it is, it looks dangerous.
Lava is one of the hottest substances that exists. And Scarecrow's terror of it. He'd go up in flames if he got too close.
Oh.
Well, I'll do a little scouting about up ahead while you look for Scarecrow.
Right.
I'd better go with you, TikTok.
Disappointed in me?
Don't be silly, and don't be afraid. We'll find a path around the river.
Oh, I hope so.
Once past the river of lava, they arrive at a mysterious gateway.
Maybe we're going to meet some gnomes at last,
Yes.
Possibly even the king himself. My tinker senses that's the entrance to the royal palace.
Uh-oh, trouble.
Nah, the king will handle them.
They soon reach the throne room, and the gnome king...
Oh!
Did you just say something, TikTok?
Not me, Dorothy. Did you think you heard a voice?
Welcome to my kingdom, upstarts. Intrude at your leisure. That means come in, you sun-soakers, and be quick about it, please.
Oh.
Looks like a gallery of some kind, doesn't it?
A collection of creatures by the look of it.
No, my ticker senses they're just ornaments, Dorothy.
Some of them look scary.
So my collection impresses you, does it? Well, it should. It's totally unique. Now then, you are probably wondering why I'm not surprised to see you. Simple. I'd like to know what's going on above my own roof. And I find your mission to rescue the prince laughable. You see?
Is that so? Well, sorry, but we're not leaving without him.
You may not leave at all, Miss Dorothy. So don't you get fresh with me. I may look cuddly, but I'm not. I'm a tyrant, remember? So grovel or get up, understand?
Well, I won't grovel. But I'm sorry if I snapped at you. We don't want any trouble, Your Highness. All we want is the prince.
The prince, huh? What are you going to give me for him?
We'll consider thanking you. You are holding him against his will.
Well, I'm afraid a thank you's not enough, surface stalker. I've never been much for sentiment. I deal in cold hard goodies. Yep, goodies and games, those are my favorite things. What puts a thank you to a guy who can dry up oceans?
Huh? Oh.
That's right. I dried up that desert you crossed. Oh, I've got powers you never dreamed of. But I have to admit, giving that pesky ocean the heave-ho was one of my better stunts. Oh, I just got tired of all that burbling and gurgling up there, so I pulled the plug on it. Channel the water underground and just drain the whole shebang. What a show! Went on for hours. Should have heard those sailors holler and talk about running aground. They hit the beach like a ton of bricks. Took them 2 weeks to walk back home.
Oh!
What a terrible thing to do.
Wasn't it? Was a lot of fun, though, and that's all that counts. If it ain't fun, don't do it. That's my motto.
Oh, fun is fine if it doesn't hurt anyone else. But what you did was reckless and dangerous. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Right, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Don't you dare lecture me. Only my personal royal lecturer is allowed to do that, and he's on tour, so lay off.
I won't lay off. Drying up the ocean was disgraceful, and kidnapping the Prince of Ev was even worse. Release him at once.
Maybe I will, and maybe I won't. Depends on which I decide is more fun.
Huh? When you say fun's all that counts, you really mean it, don't you?
Of course I do. I'm the most fun-loving tyrant that ever was. Aren't you listening? You need a good winding. Ah. You want the prince? Tell you what, we'll play a little game. If you can find him, you can have him. Won't that be fun? You never will, though.
Huh? What do you mean we never will?
Well, he hasn't been himself lately. You see, I've put him under a magic spell.
Oh! Oh, dear!
That's awful!
What kind of a spell?
A nasty one, I assume.
But just for fun. Just for fun, I'll even give you a clue, though I can't say you deserve it. The prince is out in the hall you just walked through. He's one of the ornaments.
He what?
Yep, made him part of my collection soon as he got here.
Oh, how dreadful! You're the meanest person I ever met! Break that spell and set him free or else!
Or else what? Don't forget, Dorothy, I possess great magical powers. You only made it here because I wanted to have some fun. I could have stopped you long ago. So be a good girl and play the game. It's your only chance. The princess too. I'll explain the rules. Each of you will enter the main hall and select the ornament you think is the prince. Then you will touch it. If it is the prince, he will resume his human form and you will all be free to go. But should you touch an ornament that is not the prince, you will have lost the game and will be forced to pay the price. You too will become an ornament like the prince. Soon I will have 5 new ornaments to add to my collection. Oh, this is the ballroom. To make it easier for you, I've had all the ornaments moved in here, including your prince. Just choose him and he's all yours.
Are all of these ornaments people that you've put under a spell, Your Majesty?
Most of them. Now, just make your selection, touch it, and you'll know you blew it when you turn into long sculpture, or bookends, or a weather vane. I don't care what you turn into as long as it isn't more bowling trophies.
We just touch the one we choose?
That's right. That's all there is to it. And if it is the prince, then you're home free. The spell will be broken instantly. He'll return to human form, and you could all make tracks. Otherwise, you're mine.
I'm sure I can pick the right one. Remember my built-in guess-o-meter? That should do the trick. I'll just let it guess which one's the prince.
But that's just guessing.
Now, the only way to do that is to use our powers of reasoning. Focus our intellectual capacities on the problem of selecting which ornament is the prince. Of course, this could take a while, so I think I'll sit down to concentrate. Being on my feet all day. There we go. Now I'm giving the problem my total attention. Boy, oh boy, am I thinking. Wow, what a wonderful thought that was.
Glad to hear it.
Strange, I feel a little stiff. Dizzy, too. Maybe I'm concentrating too hard.
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe you're touching an ornament.
Huh?
Up! You've got to get up, TikTok, as fast as you can.
I don't think I can, Scarecrow, silly me. What's happening? I'm milking! Help somebody! Oh!
this into my collection. Whoopee! Never.
Oh, won't you please turn him back into TikTok? He didn't touch one of the ornaments on purpose.
What do I care if he meant to or not? He knew the rules. Not my fault if he's too dumb to watch where he sits down.
Oh.
Ah, Lord Calico, my faithful second in command. About time you got here.
Sorry, I hope I haven't missed any fun.
One down, four to go. A seat cushion, nothing fancy, but we'll do better as soon as our next victims get around to making up their minds. Now, what I want you to do is keep an eye on them so they don't cheat.
Yes, we mustn't have cheating. We play fair, so they should too, right, sir?
Something like that. This is the noble Lord Calico, who will be with each of you while you play the game of finding the prince. He'll see to it you play fair. Because if there's anything we gnomes can't stand, it's cheating.
Yes, Your Honesty. You never spoke a truer word.
All right, enough chit-chat. Let's play. I don't know who's going next, but shake a leg, huh?
Yes, do. Don't want to keep your friend waiting.
Hey, maybe we'll get another pink flamingo, huh?
For a match set.
Oh, I suppose I might as well go next.
Really? You've made up your mind?
I just want to get it over with, Dorothy.
Maybe Lion will find the prince.
Well, I hope he does. But I can't say I trust this Lord Calico fella. He looks sneaky. I think we should check on him.
I'm not worried about Lion.
Huh? Scarecrow, come on. Lion doesn't have your brain to help him figure out which ornament to choose. He could end up like TikTok.
What should I do? Any ideas?
Yes, give him some advice.
But I already have.
Huh?
I told him to follow his nose.
What?
To use his sense of smell. If he can pick up the prince's scent, he'll know which one to choose.
Yes, of course. Brilliant, Scarecrow. I forgot about Lion's sense of smell.
If he can pick up the prince's royal aroma, he should win the game. He memorized his scent by sniffing some of his clothing back in the land of Ev.
Sure.
A regal plaster eagle for the king of the forest. Perfect, Calico.
Where'd you like me to put it, sire?
Let's put it. Where would I like you to put it? How about the entrance to the new hall? Need something impressive there. He'll do just fine. Well, who shall we do next, Calico?
According to the rules, your funniness, we ought to let our guests choose for themselves.
Hey, I just had a great idea. When we've got him all, we'll just put him with the Prince of Ev. That way he'll have found them at last, and wait till they see what he is.
Careful, sire.
Well, now, where were we? Oh, yes, rules say you get to choose who's next.
The Tin Woodman volunteers to give Scarecrow time to think.
Tin Man, I'm officially here to see you don't cheat, but feel free to ask for my advice.
Thanks, but your advice I don't need. Now, I think I'll take a minute to look around before I choose.
Of course, take your time. Are you going to try and sniff him out too, like poor Lion?
No, Calico, I'll let my heart be my guide.
Your heart, huh? This I've got to see.
It's never wrong. It's a special one that the Wizard of Oz made just for me.
Well, well, bully for him. I'm sure my advice is no match for the wizard's heart, so I'll just observe.
Oh, you'll have to do more than that.
Huh?
Yep, my heart's just told me what I should do, and it says I should get a helping hand from you. You see, I'm not going to use my hand to choose. I'm going to use yours, just to make sure that the one I choose is the prince.
Are you out of your mind? I wouldn't touch one of those ornaments with a 10-foot beam.
No? Well, I'll give you a choice. Either you touch the prince, or I get very upset.
Go ahead. You don't scare me.
Oh, don't I?
Help! I think I'm being threatened.
Hush. Now then, keep quiet and behave. You'll be just fine. Promise not to make a sound? Good.
Help! Someone!
So much for keeping your promises, huh? Well, we'll give it another try.
Quick, guard! Guard!
Sort of a slow learner, aren't you, Calico?
Quick, someone help me!
Stubborn, aren't we? Guess we'll have to try something different. Of course, if you decide to touch the prince, your troubles are over. He and the others will return to normal and we'll leave quietly. Where shall we start? I know. I'll just walk around and you tell me when to stop. But don't try anything funny. Remember, it's your hand that's going to touch the ornament, not mine. Oh, look at this snake. It reminds me so much of you. Why don't I bring you together? Huh?
No, no, no. Someone help!
Say, how about this lizard? Think he could be the prince? Let's find out. Touch him, Calico. What about this thing? It looks sort of regal. Tell you what, why don't you choose, okay? I'm afraid I don't understand what you're trying to say, Calico. Why not use a little sign language? Oh, well, I have nowhere special to go today. I guess I'll just wait until you feel like pointing. Hey, are you all right? Gosh, I hope I haven't hurt him. Hey! I only meant to scare you. Come on! Up and at him, Calico! Wakey, wakey! Hey, come on, shake a leg! Rise and shine! Lord Calico, yoo-hoo!
Huh? Yeah. Oh, get me out of here!
Oh, well, he's alive anyway.
No! Keep away from me!
Help! Before I get mad!
God!
Oh!
I sure hope my brain is up to this. Whew. I've had time to think, but I'm not sure I'm on the right track. Well, let's see. Come on, brain, think. Doesn't help having that sneaky Lord Calico watching me like a hawk. You can come out. I know you're up there.
No, thanks. I'll stay put. I'm hiding.
Fine, stay there. I don't want you near me anyway. I don't know how, but I'm sure you made the others lose.
I had nothing to do with the fate of your friends. Nothing. They thought they knew which ornament was the Prince of Ev, and they were wrong.
I suppose I do need help. There's so many ornaments to choose from. I can't figure out just where I should start. I mean, the prince could be one of these pots for all I know. Oh dear, whatever shall I do? My brain's all fuddled.
He's supposed to be smart. Sounds to me like our little game is already too much for him.
Now let me see. When a prince is under a spell, I suppose he'd turn into something regal. Something really high class, like a crown studded with jewels. Or maybe something simple and elegant. I bet this is the prince right here. A jar of classic proportions, always in good taste. Yes, I'll try this one. I'm sure it's the Prince of Ev.
No, please don't.
Why not?
That's such a boring looking object. It couldn't be the prince.
Oh, so that's it. If the object is plain and simple, it couldn't be the prince, right? Because the prince is royal and fancy and not simple. Of course, you could be lying, are you?
No, I'm not lying to you. I can assure you the prince is a lot fancier than that thing.
That means this jar can't be the prince. I'll have to keep looking around, I guess.
That's right. Now just go over there and look around at the more interesting kinds of objects, okay?
Now let me see, where could he be? A picture frame, that might be him. Princes usually have their portraits framed.
The prince wouldn't be turned into an empty old picture frame.
All right, I'll look around some more. A handy cabinet for keeping things in? Maybe that's the prince. I hear he's very organized.
A prince in a kitchen cupboard?
How about a bed or a table, a chair, maybe a stool?
No, none of that. No furniture. And if you will take my advice, I'll give you a bonus.
You will?
If you don't find the prince, I'll see you turn into whatever you choose.
Oh, thanks a lot. I'm gonna find something very nice to become. That three-legged umbrella stand is interesting, but no. The king should get a really extraordinary ornament. Boy, there's so much stuff to choose from. A teapot? A weather vane? Nah, a goldfish bowl. Gosh, it's so hard to choose. Oh-ho! Yeah. Maybe one of these. What do you think, Lord Calico?
Good. The king loves swans. Can't get enough of them. I'm sure he'd be tickled pink if you became another swan.
Say, this is nice. How about if I turn into a deer? I'd love that.
Great. Touch it. Touch it. Good choice.
Okay, I'll do it. Gosh, I don't know. Look at all those great things over there. Wow.
No, wait.
Now, there's something I'd love to be. It looks awful familiar. That couldn't be lion, could it?
Impossible! How do you know that, you beat?
No, the king told us. Remember? He couldn't help bragging about how he outsmarted Lion. He had a big laugh about it. Lion was using his sense of smell to find the prince, so I bet you anything he's around here someplace. Now, which of these things is the prince? This kangaroo? Not too clumsy. This mouse? Not too small.
Oh, get away from there! Please, you're making me nervous. Oh, I'm going to fall!
Well, I must be on to something if Calico's joining me.
Wait!
It is a nice elephant, though.
Touch it. Okay, please. Elephant's an excellent choice. Mickey, I'm sure he's the one.
So big. It certainly is an impressive-looking creature, I have to admit. But so are some of the others.
I thought you liked the elephant.
I do, I do. Oh! Look at that!
Please,
wow!
Touch the elephant. It will make my job so much easier.
Hey now, look at this tiger. I'd love to turn into this. Would it make the king happy if I did?
I'll lose my head if he touches that.
Calico, anything wrong? You sound upset.
Do I? begging you. Try and find another ornament.
Oh, you mean you'd rather I didn't touch this tiger?
Yes, exactly.
Is it because there's more interesting stuff around?
That's right. Much more interesting than that little old tiger, like over there.
Gee, I don't know. This is such a fascinating work of art. I'm tempted to touch it. Always wanted to be a cat. Why not? I can keep lying company. Here goes.
Yeah, stop! Leave it alone!
Oof, gosh, I'm doing it wrong, huh? Should I use one hand instead of two? Whoa!
This is too small. You should be something bigger.
Aw, but it looks awfully cute and cuddly.
It's not, it's ugly.
Oh?
You deserve to be grander, more elegant. This is nothing.
Thanks. How considerate of you, Calico.
Don't thank me. Just find something else to touch.
Oh, no. I've found what I'm looking for. There's absolutely no need to look further. Know what I mean?
How come you're smiling?
Because I'm about to win the game, my friend. You see, I know now where to find the prince.
You do?
You forget that I have a special first-class brain, and your advice led me to the prince.
Not me! I never told you where he was!
Well, you didn't mean to, but the tiger's the only object you didn't want me to touch, so it must be him.
You're cheating! You're not playing fair!
Now, when I touch the prince, that should break the spells Tin Man, Lion, and TikTok are under, too.
Oh, gotta stop him. Bullseye! That was too close for comfort. The king would have had me boiled in love if he'd won.
Found him. You're in deep trouble, Calico.
I don't want to be boiled in lava.
Come on, look for her. Well, where is she?
I'll keep looking.
Keep looking.
Yoo-hoo, Prince. Prince Ev, is that you?
Dorothy, hello. Ooh. Here I am.
Where, Prince Ev?
Over here. Come on.
Prince, she's talking to him. Calico, come back here.
What is it?
The prince. Check the prince.
Oh.
You heard the prince speak, sir.
I think so. We gotta see if that tiger ornament's still in its place.
But, sire, if you heard him speak, it can't be there.
Fool, this might just be a sneaky trick. Okay, it's supposed to be around here somewhere, right? Gotta go. Look, he's here, and he's still a tiger, too.
Oh, thank goodness. You were right, sire. She's playing a little game of some sort.
Yes. Who's she talking to? Who? Dorothy.
Surprise, Your Majesty. Thanks for leading me straight to the prince.
What?
Princess, I finally found you. And now that I have, I can set you free.
Ah, my most valuable prize of all. Don't do it.
Oh, why isn't it changing? I won the game fair and square.
Oh, no, you've broken my magic spell. Within a week, my whole collection will come back to life. I won't have anything to play with as a calico.
Watch out!
Rats!
I remember that globe. It used to be a friend.
Oh. First, Lord Calico tricks Scarecrow into losing, then he tries to drop him on our heads.
Oh, and to think all those days of fun-filled treachery are gone forever.
My spine. Dorothy, am I ever glad you found me.
How do you feel, Scarecrow?
Oh, I better check. I'm a little bent out of shape in places, but other than that, I'm fine.
What a mess! This game was a big mistake! I'll never play again!
The Prince of Ev also knows which ornaments are lion and the Tin Woodman, and Dorothy quickly frees them.
Calico! Calico! I led them right to the prince, but who'd you expect me to blame? Me? It's my fault I lost my collection, not yours, and you are gonna pay for it.
You okay?
Troops! We got a crisis on our hands! I gotta get some outsiders who beat me at my own game!
Now it's TikTok's turn.
Wake up now. Time to wake up. Hello, TikTok? Oh, no one's here.
The king wouldn't let us leave this easily.
I'm sure he's planning something mean. It's too quiet in here.
Well, let's just keep moving toward the door.
Tin Man's right. There's nothing else we can do.
Scarecrow, come on!
I thought I heard footsteps coming this way. Looks like we have no choice but to go through this door, but it leads back through the palace. I don't like it.
Me neither.
Oh, well. It's open, but we'll have to be careful. I doubt the Gnome King's gonna let us just walk away. He's sure to be a sore loser, so move quickly and quietly.
Oh, well, here goes.
Hold it!
What's the matter? Don't go in.
My ticker senses danger. My ticker says the danger's getting closer, not farther away. Guess-a-meter would tell me what to do.
It
Must be on the fleet.
Come on, Tick-Tock. You're falling behind. Hurry.
What a time to break down.
Our little plan's going well, Sire. I can't wait till they see our surprise.
I wonder what that terrible king is going to do to stop us. He's not going to let us leave without a fight.
Well, I'm ready.
Right, I'm ready too.
I just want to go home.
Well, we made it this far.
True, but there's a lot more.
Oh, now my gasometer's working, but it's gone wild. I can't stop it.
Oh. Look, no one's here either.
Yeah, I don't like this at all.
All those doorways, and there's no way to tell which one we ought to take.
Gotcha! It'll look so nice stuck on my throne.
If you let my friends go, then it's a deal.
It's my duty to save the prince. Take me.
Never forget they spoke, you monster. You can't have them. They're our friends.
Gonna play hard to get, huh? Well, I think maybe I can convince you to change your minds. You just wait.
We'll never change our minds.
Look!
Oh no!
Watch out!
I don't care what's broken. Yup,
I'm gonna take you apart anyway, so what difference does it make?
You're right. Now my ticker says we're safe.
Safe, huh? Your ticker needs a tuna for sure.
Oh!
Yow! Get away from me! No! No, not that! Anything but that! Out of my way!
Why, there's an egg in your head.
Keep that egg head away from me. You know eggs are poison for no.
Get out of here.
I brought you something to remember me by, Tip-Top.
Hey, they both ran away.
We're saved. Saved by an egg.
Hooray! Melina's egg saved the day.
Hooray!
We're safe. The king chickened out.
Oh, I thought we'd lost you.
Yeah.
I forgot all about putting it in there for safekeeping. Whoopee! Whoopee! Oh, thank you, Belita! Yahoo!
I'll get you yet.
Any luck, Tin Man?
Nothing in here but mushrooms, Dorothy.
My ticker senses no exit here.
There are so many tunnels.
Too many.
Well, we'll just have to keep looking till we find the right one.
There's nothing down at that end but boulders and dead-end caves, Dorothy. At the rate we're going, we'll never find our way out of this place.
Oh, dear. This is terrible. We escaped from the palace just to get stuck here. We can't wait.
Oh, Dorothy.
Don't give up.
There must be a way out someplace.
Let me think. He let all the water out of the ocean by pulling out the plug, remember?
Uh-huh. I remember. But how's that going to help us find our way out of these caves, Scarecrow?
It's simple, really. There has to be a hole that leads from the desert into these caves. The hole that the ocean water poured through.
Oh.
All we have to do is find it, then climb out through it to the surface. Do you see?
Uh-huh.
Huh?
I must admit, that was probably my best idea ever. What a brain!
But how will we find this hole?
What's up there? Dripping water. We're near the only body of water we've seen here in Gnomeland.
The underground river.
Yes, that we passed on our way here.
Oh, that could mean...
that the river water was once the ocean water, and that the source of the river must be at the bottom of the hole where the ocean was drained.
Oh.
Come on, everyone!
Oh, I hope Scarecrow's right. I can't wait to get away from Gnomeland.
They soon find the river and are eagerly following it to its source. Maybe a little too eagerly.
We've got him now, Calico, at last. Come on, you smart Alex, just a bit closer.
Could be just around this bend.
Right.
Straight ahead of
me. Oh, yes, I see it now.
Ticker says too far to run without great danger of obliteration. But we can't stay here.
We'll have to go now. They're pinpointing our position. I'll go first. I can hold them off if they come down after me.
Good luck, Tin Man.
Hey! Fire!
Let's go! Run, Brian!
Oh, I don't understand it.
We got him where we want him, and we still can't get him. Look, look at him go!
Come after us up here.
Safe at last. But they all agree there's one stop they should make before heading home.
Oh,
mess. I was hoping they'd be inside the thing at least. Now what am I supposed to do with an old ship?
Put it in a bottle, sire. Sorry, sire. Now what, sire? Is there anything I can get you?
My revenge.
Huh?
Pack your pointy hat, Calico. We're going to Oz.
You know something? I'm pooped. I think I'm gonna go home.
Me too, Lion. I need a few days to rest up, get some sleep, do a little light thinking.
I'm looking forward to going home too, Dorothy. I'm starting to worry about my Winkies. I am their king, you know.
I'll have to check on my subjects in the forest too, soon as I wake up.
Dorothy, first I'll go with you to see Glinda. She'll send you home. And on the way to Glinda's, we can stop and tell Ozma the whole story.
Must be nice to have somewhere to go. Oh, well, that's the way the egg boils.
Why don't you come home with TikTok and me? I'll make you my royal alarm clock, as long as you don't crow till noon, that is.
That means I'd love to!
Goodbye, everyone!
Goodbye!
Goodbye,
TikTok!
Goodbye! Goodbye, TikTok!
And so, the Tin Woodman heads home to his Winkies and Lion home to his forest. The prince will rule wisely in the land of Ev with TikTok and Billina's help.
Yes.
wants you to